How does deodorant work? You stink. Sorry to be so brutally honest about this, but it's better that you hear it from me than by finding a growing pile of soap or perfume left for you by your work colleagues or your family members. Your natural aroma is actually the result of various things, including your diet, your genetic makeup, but the primary suspect is the apricine sweat gland, present in both your armpits and what is delicately termed your genital region. Each of your pits contains up to 50,000 of these glands, and the average human produces a litre of sweat every day. But sweat itself doesn't smell strongly. It's basically just water and various salts. Body odour is the result of billions of microorganisms that live on your skin, mostly bacteria. The majority of these are not harming you and may even offer positive benefits like stimulating your skin's immune system. But some of these, especially members of the Corynebacterium clan, manufacture enzymes that break down your honest, hard-working sweat into a variety of acids, many of which, including propionic and butyric acids, and especially trans-3-methylhexiomic acid, stink. Your armpits and your pubic region are also likely to contain thousands of thin, wiry hairs, broadly similar to the ones that Jeremy Clarkson has on his head. And these act to wick this pungent mixture, exposing more of it to the air to help it spread further and faster, and potentially enabling you to clear out a whole room by the simple act of walking into it. Humans aren't alone in having a tendency to make strong smells. Many animals have serious BO too, and in the wild it can be a huge advantage, marking out territory, attracting mates or repelling enemies, or even, in the case of those creatures that feign death to avoid getting eaten, to persuade potential predators that they are already rotting and not very palatable. But for humans, smelling strongly is rarely regarded as a good thing. And another problem is that our favoured way to clean ourselves, through the use of soap, can actually intensify this natural aroma. Naturally, our skin tends to be slightly acidic, but soap is alkaline, and using it repeatedly encourages more alkaline-loving bacteria to flock to us, which is where deodorant comes in, killing or suppressing the bacteria through being mildly acidic, and usually also carrying some perfume elements as well to make us smell nicer. It's not a new idea. Naturally occurring deodorizing salts have been used for thousands of years, but it took the marketing departments of big cosmetic companies and the threat that your BO was turning you into the office bogeyman to see the idea really take off. Because modern deodorants don't just make you smell fractionally fresher, they also serve as antiperspirants, reducing the amount you sweat. The modern antiperspirant was invented in the 1940s by a man with the spectacularly French name of Jules Montagnier. Sadly, from the point of view of me now making a cheap gag about the French buying less deodorant than any other developed country, Montagnier was actually from Chicago, so we can't do that. Antiperspirants contain an active ingredient to reduce the amount you sweat and therefore the amount of stink fuel available to the bacteria on your skin. This is almost always an aluminium compound, aluminum for our American viewers. This will usually be aluminium chlorohydrate and aluminium zirconium trichloridrex, either of which will react with the electrolytes in your sweat to create a thick gel that effectively blocks the top of your sweat glands, and which also acts astringently to cause your pores to contract, both of which will reduce the amount you sweat, and therefore the amount you smell. But is this a good thing? There have been several health scares over the years about antiperspirants, and they were briefly banned in America in the 1970s over concerns about the long-term effects of inhaling some of these aluminium compounds. But more importantly, the antiperspirant is also trying to prevent your body from doing something it does naturally and for good reason, to help regulate your body temperature. It's also treating an effect rather than a cause. Research suggests that even extreme body odor can be reduced through changes in diet and by doing more exercise. But deodorants could also be preventing more than just a few sodden shirts. There's evidence that they can reduce the effect of your pheromones, the chemical markers that we excrete and which help us to attract mates, or even just casual sexual partners. We're stinky for a reason. High karate and Old Spice never worked as well as good, honest sweat.